I mentioned ICH, a big driver, the quality initiatives, pharmaceutical development, risk management, quality management, and API development. They have a global vision. Every country has a regulatory system, and within that, there are GMPs all over the world. However, those GMPs don't cover APIs and don't cover the design of a product. If a product is designed wrong, it's not going to meet the requirements of the patient. So they came up with the concept of quality by design. Before the economic recession of 2008, every big pharma company was going gangbusters on this. Recession happened and almost everybody dropped it. Generic companies really are not into it because generic pharma companies are into first past the post. Whoever gets the approval first gets the 6 months exclusivity and is on the market. So they don't. Generic companies are not really into QBD. FDA is now pushing the QBD concept to generic manufacturers. We went through a very tough inspection recently in Hungary where the focus of the inspection was the development program. How did you come up with your critical process parameters, critical quality attributes? And that was the whole focus of the inspection. And this is the major generic company in Eastern Europe. Quality risk management, how do you design a system to prevent failure? And if you do fail, how do you react to that? And then because they realize all these things are fine, they now realize unless top management is committed and gives the money, the people, the resources to do it, it's never going to happen. They come up with what I call quality systems. And if you read section two, it's all about management. And I go to companies where the president, the directors, the vice presidents have never heard of this. And then when I start telling them you're not doing this, that, and the other, they say, why should we? And then when we go through this, they suddenly have a shock and a horror. Companies that do this stuff are more profitable than companies that don't, I will tell you that for nothing. And the new one, QBD for APIs, Q11. So, harmonized approach to development is Q8, product designed to meet patient requirements, consistently meet critical quality attributes, which need to be defined. Starting materials and the processes are understood, critical sources of process variation are identified, and you're continuously monitoring and updating your system. So if you want to do that graphically to let it sink in, quality by design is based on knowing what you want the product to do in a patient. You want it to cure a headache within 5 minutes. That's not going to be a tablet. Maybe an under the tongue little patch that you dissolve under the tongue. Then you have to design the product, know its excipients, its stability, its requirements. You need to design the process, and you need to be able to control the process and monitor the process. All that on the right is the product quality attributes, the process parameters, the process controls, and the process product specifications. Or you could say that's the product knowledge and that's the process understanding, but all of it, and this is the key one, has to be within a continuous improvement system and environment. That is really, really key. You can read that yourself. So you need to know all the parameters and dimensions defining the product. You need to know what impacts the customer requirements. And then you need to know what critical parameters contribute to product variability. That's Q8. Q9 is risk management, and you've all seen this chart. You have to have a process, you have to assess risk, control it, measure the outputs, and review the risk. You need to use tools to assess risk, and there are many of them, and you need to discuss this within departments. The old concept of silo management, production never talks to QC, who never talks to engineering, that can't work in this system. You must have interdepartmental communications routinely at all levels. That is QBD, quality by design. Designing a process that doesn't have risk, or you design the process with a known risk that you can control. And if that fails, that's your Kappa system. How do you correct and how do you prevent it happening again? All right? A very good website I would recommend to you is this one. If you Google ICH Q9 and type in the word briefing pack, it gives you little PowerPoint presentations on all the different tools you can use for risk management. And then it goes in with different departments showing how these tools can be used in different departments. So if you're in QC lab and stability studies, look at that presentation. It will tell you how to minimize risk in that department. Well worth looking at. Not very well publicized, and I don't know why. Worth going to. Q10 is management, and the key thing here is a definition of management responsibilities and who does what. Q11 is the same as the QBD and Q8, but for APIs. When you make an API, you will select the starting materials knowing that they meet GMP or your key intermediate meets GMP. You identify the important critical manufacturing steps and all the rest. You know the capacity of your process to deplete or remove impurities, something that the thalidomide manufacturer never did. You know how robust your process is. You prove your methods are suitable for validation on the small scale, that's in the pilot plant, and when it's scaled up in production. And you identify and control all your critical intermediates. It's currently a step four, which means that it's been put out for adoption by all the countries. ICH is happy with it. It's yet to be officially legally adopted by different countries. Give it another 6 months, it will be.